2 is back on Earth.
Love it. All that applause because, well, this is your morning moment. Splashdown, a SpaceX capsule carrying a former NASA astronaut and 3 paying customers came home from the International Space Station, splashing down off the coast of Panama City. It is only the 2nd all-private mission to the ISS. That, as a Chinese rocket launched from Earth to their own space station yesterday, carrying the country's first civilian astronaut into orbit. Let's talk about all this and a lot more with world-renowned astrophysicist and director of the Hayden Planetarium at the American Museum of Natural History here in New York City, Dr. Neil deGrasse Tyson, also the author of Starry Messenger, Cosmic Perspectives on Civilization. Good morning.
Hey, thanks for having me. Thank you.
Let's start with, we've been talking about China a lot this morning, and now in space too, obviously, in the space race, launching and working to put more pressure, I suppose, on NASA to put humans on course to walk the moon by 2025, 2 years away. Does this increase the pressure on NASA, what China's
doing? Well, it certainly does, of course. How could we think not?
Right.
And just look at the rebirth of our interest in returning to the moon with the Artemis program, which, by the way, not everyone knows yet. I mean, some people know, of course, that Artemis is the twin sister of Apollo. And so NASA was like woke early in this effort.
Be careful throwing that word around.
That's right. But the, you know, we could have stayed on the moon in 1972. We didn't. We could have gone back in 1980 or 1990 or 2000 or 2010. No, we have rejuvenated our lunar space program right around the time when China says that's what they want to do. So who are we kidding? If we're going to say, oh, we're just doing it because it's time to do it again. No, there are forces operating out there that rival a little bit what we felt back in the space race with the Soviet Union. So that's just the reality. To stand in denial of it would be naive.
So as we wait, as we watch for all that to play out, as if we see if it will happen by 2025 in terms of the moon, I was really fascinated, the James Webb Telescope.
Oh.
I love it anytime.
It is all
we
that.
We get a little nugget. All that and
it
more.
It is all that and more.
So now it's observed a donut of water, as I understand it, around Saturn, beyond the rings. What does this actually mean? What is the donut of water?
Well, just to say, the search for water is a major objective of NASA because every place on Earth we find water, we find life, even the Dead Sea. It was called the Dead Sea because no one then had microscopes or the James Webb Space Telescope. So if we know that life and water go together and we want to find life elsewhere, you're going to look for water any place you can find it in any shape, form, always. So these outer planets, not only Jupiter, but Saturn as well, there are conditions there that can support water. And in many cases, it's frozen on the surface of moons, but then it's liquefied inside because the moons are stressed by the tidal forces of the main planet and other moons. And it's like when you hit a racquetball, they say, let's warm up the ball. You're literally warming up the ball by stressing it and popping it back into shape. That's what's happening with moons in the outer solar system, which renders what would otherwise be frozen water liquid. So when you find water in the outer solar system, it widens the net that you cast in your search for life.
Can we talk about what we're seeing in New York that apparently everyone knew about except for me?
You got to get out more.
That is the truest statement of the morning.
There it is. Yes, Manhattan Henge.
Okay.
Yes. So.
Did you coin that term?
What's that?
What is it?
I coined that term. Yeah. And it's now in the Oxford English Dictionary, I'm happy to say. Yeah.
Wow.
It's like an official, it's not official until that happens.
Not just the Urban Dictionary, in the Oxford English
Exactly. Because anything's in the Urban Dictionary. But on 2 occasions a year, around Memorial Day, and I time this up with baseball's All-Star break. That's what I found these on the calendar. On those 2 occasions, the sun sets exactly on the grid of Manhattan. And it makes for spectacular sunsets. Sunsets are beautiful regardless. Mm-hmm. Now you frame them with the steel and glass structures of the city. Thousands of people now crowd the streets. And I'm delighted to announce we finally stopped traffic for reasons other than Con Ed digging holes or police activity. So if the universe can call to us that way, it's just a reminder that we are participants in the great unfolding of cosmic events.
I think about it.
I love that.
I love it.
Before you go, since you have a term in the Oxford English Dictionary.
I don't mean to brag or anything.
Can we also get your best
humble brag?
This is CNN This Morning, because you were doing it in the commercial and it was pretty darn great.
Oh, this is CNN This Morning.
There you go. That's all you need to know. Hired. All right. Dr. Neil deGrasse Tyson, what a pleasure. Thank you.
Welcome to the universe.
Also, even better.
Also great.